So we've learned about transpose matrices, and we've learned about inverse matrices. So there's another type of matrix called an orthogonal matrix. This is a special type of matrix that makes use of transposes and inverses. So the interesting thing about an orthogonal matrix is that the inverse of an orthogonal matrix is equal to the transpose of the matrix. Okay. So what does that mean? Well, we can look at that. That means that Q times Q transpose is equal to the identity matrix, right? So Q, this when we do Q times Q transpose, we're going across the row of Q down the column of Q transpose. But down the column of Q transpose is the same thing as going across the row of Q. So Q times Q transpose is like multiplying the row of Q against the row of Q, right? That's equal to the identity matrix. So if the rows are the same, then you get 1. If the rows are different, then you get 0. That's the definition of orthonormality, right? Orthonormal vectors. So the rows of Q are orthonormal vectors, right? When you multiply them against each other, you get 1. And when you multiply different rows together, you get 0. But we can write this just as well as Q transpose Q equals I. Here, we're going across the rows of Q transpose, which is the same as going down the columns of Q. And we're going down the columns of Q. So here, we're multiplying the column of Q against the column of Q. And if they're same, we get 1. And if they're different, we get 0. So the columns of Q also form orthonormal vectors. So an orthogonal matrix is special in that both its rows are orthonormal and its columns are orthonormal. There's one other thing that's special about orthogonal matrices. If we look at Q times X, so here we have an n by n orthogonal matrix times a column vector, which n rows one column. And we take the transpose of that, and we multiply that times Q X, right? What is this thing? This is just the, by definition, right? This is just the length of Q X squared, right? So what is QX transpose times QX? This is equal to AB transpose is B transpose A transpose. So this is X transpose Q transpose times QX. But Q transpose Q is the identity matrix, right? And a matrix times the identity matrix is equal to the matrix itself, whether it's a column vector or a row vector, it doesn't matter. So then this is just X transpose X. And that's the norm of X squared, OK? So we have the norm of QX, this one, is equal to the norm of X. So that tells us that Q preserves norm. So an orthogonal matrix, or preserves norms or preserves length, right? The norm is the length of a vector. Preserves length. So that's a very important characteristic of an orthogonal matrix. And this is the reason why orthogonal matrices play such important roles in physics, in engineering. Okay, in the next video, I want to show you a nice example of an orthogonal matrix. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.